The reason why this is also taking some time is because it's very complex to think about how these work with the legal and regulatory environment that we have. So in the cryptocurrency space, we talk about, or I talk about, the triple nature of crypto assets. So in the normal world, we usually have these, they're separate. We have stocks and bonds are one thing. We have currency, that's one thing. We all know that, you know, a stock is something different than a Norwegian crown. And things that you buy, software, it's something different. But in the cryptocurrency world, they kind of melt together and become one, or they become a new thing, or they move within this diagram. So if you launch your utility token and say to the regulators, well, now guys, this is not a security, it's not a currency, this is just access to software. That's basically what it is. So you don't have to regulate it, it's fine. Okay, you launch this product and then this network becomes huge and everyone uses it. So access to these tokens become really valuable. So what's happening? Well, you can use them as currency because everyone wants them, everyone knows it's valuable, and it's super easy to exchange. So we have now a currency and access to software being the same thing. So people realize that, well, I'm just gonna invest into these new companies because it's gonna give me a lot of future, you know, revenues because I can sell them later. So then it becomes a security, but it's not really a security as we have defined them earlier, but it's all of them. And if they fail, then it's not really a good investment, so it's not really a security. It might not be functioning as a currency, it just might be staying in this little bubble here. So understanding how this works and getting the correct legal framework and regulatory framework to make these tokens attractive and functioning is gonna be the challenge that we're gonna have to, you know, meet in the upcoming years to make this work.